One summer day in 1961, Dr. Marshall Nirenberg grabbed the biomedical brass ring and overnight went from obscurity to stardom within the scientific community. And by 1968, he had garnered both the National Medal of Science and the Nobel Prize. The story really begins in New York City, 1941, when Marshall Nirenberg was 14 years old. That's when he was stricken with rheumatic fever, prompting the family to move from New York to Orlando, Florida. Now, it was pre-Disney Orlando, and it was there, roaming the swamps and woods, that young Nirenberg fell in love with the natural world around him.
When I was 13 or 14, collected spiders for the American Museum of Natural History, and got all the kids in the neighborhood to help collect the spiders. And, you know, being there was a wonderful opportunity.
And while still just a kid, Nirenberg met and was befriended by a group of biologists, ornithologists, and entomologists who were in Florida teaching jungle survival to military pilots.
They oriented me even more than I had been oriented before towards biology, towards science, and they were good positive influences, wonderful influences actually.
Nirenberg became a keen observer of plant life, birds, and insects, filling notebooks with graphic details of his observations, and that training served him well in his later scientific pursuits. After BS and master's degrees from the University of Florida, Marshall Nirenberg matriculated at the University of Michigan, where his research and subsequent PhD led to a postdoctoral fellowship at the NIH's National Institute of Arthritis, Metabolism, and Digestive Diseases.
The NIH is a wonderful place. It's there's no frills here, but there's a wonderful opportunity to do research.
He came to NIH in 1957, and just 11 years later, Nirenberg would win the Nobel Prize for deciphering the genetic code. His investigations of the relationship between DNA and RNA and the production of proteins paved the way for groundbreaking work in cracking the code. Nirenberg's life changed forever in 1961. That's when he married Parola Zaltzman, a Brazilian biochemist. And that summer, at the International Congress of Biochemistry in Moscow, he presented his early work on deciphering the genetic code. Some in attendance recall being electrified. Suddenly, Marshall Nirenberg, whom the Washington Post described as painfully modest, was world famous, which prompted his former advisor at the University of Michigan to write a letter in which he jokingly suggested that he might put up a sign outside his house saying, "Painted by Marshall Nirenberg, AD 1953. Despite numerous job offers from prestigious institutions around the world, Nirenberg chose to stay at NIH. And in 1962, he was appointed chief of the section on biochemical genetics at the National Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute. By 1966, Nirenberg had deciphered the 64 RNA codons for all 20 major amino acids. Codons are the code words of messenger RNA. That same year, President Lyndon Johnson awarded Dr. Nirenberg the National Medal of Science. And in 1968, Nirenberg's place among the scientific elite was secured when he was awarded the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine. But Dr. Nirenberg was already undergoing a professional metamorphosis. He wasn't about to rest on his laurels.
It's like turning a crank, and I could do it with one hand tied behind my back. So I wanted more of a challenge, and I was always interested in neurobiology. I didn't know anything about neurobiology, really, but even before working on the code, I had wondered about going into neurobiology. So I decided to change fields and try to explore in neurobiology.
Of all the awards and honors garnered over a half century of scientific exploration, you'll never guess Dr. Nirenberg's favorite.
My favorite, if you really want to know my favorite, is I gave a talk in a middle school one time for little kids, and they gave me an award at the end of the talk that was a bronze hall pass, a lifetime hall pass that allowed me to to go in the hall, to go to the bathroom, anytime I wanted to. That's my favorite award of all of them.
For more than a quarter century now, Dr. Nirenberg has maintained his position as senior research biochemist and chief of the Laboratory of Biochemical Genetics at the National Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute.
Throughout the years, of course, there have been many opportunities to go take other positions elsewhere, in universities and so forth. And almost invariably, the pay is higher, you get more space elsewhere, you can work with more people, and certainly I would say the prestige is higher. But I've never found a place where I thought it would be better, where I thought I could do better research than at the NIH.
And through the years, Dr. Nirenberg has always demonstrated a strong activist tendency when it comes to taking a stand on social or political issues related to science. He believes strongly in using the clout that comes with being a Nobel laureate.
Absolutely. I think that's important.